अरे ओम, नाउ आई एम गोइंग टू एक्सप्लेन द बेसिक पायनियर बुक ऑन योग. द नेम ऑफ द बुक इज योग सूत्र एंड दैट हैज बीन रिटन बाय ऋषि, यू कैन कॉल एज अ साइंटिस्ट इन एंशियंट पीरियड, पतंजलि. तो पतंजलि इज द नेम ऑफ अ पर्सन who has composed all these yogic practices to formulate the science of yoga. And of course, he has given the name to the book as Yoga Sutra. This book is in definitely Sanskrit. Sanskrit is the ancient language of India. Previously, that was the language used in day-to-day life throughout India. Nowadays we have got different languages, but most of them are originated from Sanskrit only. So this book is in Sanskrit, so we have to understand some Sanskrit words and meaning and all that. Of course, we are not going to learn the language Sanskrit as it is. We will just understand the meaning of the words which are used by Patanjali. Now we have to consider this word sutra. Sutra is a format to write, just as prose, poetry, drama, different formats are there. Sutra also is one of the format, and this was very popularly used in ancient period in India for many of the books. You must know the reason, because sutra contains minimum number of words. That is a very speciality of this, and that is why there is no verb. So verb we have to understand by the references, because it reduces the number of words. Of course, large meaning is compressed form in sutra. Now, why this format is used and why it was popular, that is also important to know. Because this book has been written or developed, we can say, about 2500 years back. And now we have to consider the social environment during that period, preferably in India or even everywhere. Very ancient period, there are no latest developments there. Of course, no computer, no typewriter, even there were no paper and pencil to write. So how the people were writing? Nothing was there to write. Language was there, writing system was there, but they were writing on the tree leaves. Long tree leaves, they are available in nature. And they were engraving on the tree leaf with a fork. That is also available on the tree. So that was a system to write. And now the tree leaves are perishable. They can't last long. So after a certain period, again, they have to write a copy on a new tree leaves. And that was very difficult. So the best way to recite. The people were reciting all the things. And the total books and knowledge came to us through the recitation, through the generations after generations. And that is why the sutra format is very useful, because it contains minimum number of words. So it was easy to recite, but at the same time it becomes difficult to understand, because there was no detailed explanation. The total meaning is in a compressed form. Minimum words. So definitely we also come to know that some difficulties in understanding the sutras. But when the development has started, the paper has been invented, and now these things were written form are available. Many commentators also have come up. They have written the commentaries on Patanjali Yoga Sutras. So we have got number of commentaries presently available in most of the languages in the world for the Patanjali Yoga Sutra. And because of different commentators, there are differences of opinion also is there. But as a beginner, we need not discuss and worry about this difference of opinion. We'll go out sutra by sutra. We'll try to understand the meaning of the words. And some little commentary on the particular sutra. So that we'll have the complete idea of the book written by Patanjali. As I told you, this is a sutra book. So every sutra has been given the number. So there are 196 sutras. That's all. It's very small. If you type it on the paper, it may be 5-6 papers only. So such a small book is there, but it contains large amount of knowledge about yoga. So we'll be learning one by one in different parts of this series. Hari Om.